Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and salam sejahtera everyone. So for this video, we are going to focus on the last subtopic in this chapter, which is 4.6 transitions elements. So last time we have learned about groups, right? So group 18, group 1, group 17, and then we proceed with elements in period 3. So this time around, we have to focus on transitions elements. Okay, transitions elements are known also known as transition metal. Why? Because all the elements in transitions elements are metals. So, daripada group mana ke mana? So, transition elements are from group 3 to group 12 in periodic tables. Alright, so these are example of transitions element. Actually, there are a lot of transitions element that we have in periodic tables. So, example is chromium, manganese, iron and copper. So where can we find them in periodic table? So look at the yellow portion here. So all these elements are transitions element from group 3 until group 12. Okay. Alright. So for your information, transitions element are metals, just like what I said before. And then they all have special characteristics. Okay, so before kita pergi kepada special characteristic, so kita akan fokus dulu pada properties. Properties ni something yang kita boleh, ciri-ciri yang kita boleh lihat lah, observe and kita boleh nampak. Okay, first, solid with shiny surfaces, since the metal, so dia ada permukaan yang shiny lah, yang berkilat. Alright, so next, very hard compared to metals in group 1 and 2. Since transition elements are heavy metals, so they are very hard. Kalau group 1 dengan 2 ni, kita boleh gunting senang je kan? Potong pakai pisau je sebab they are soft. But transitions metal, they are very hard. Okay, so they have high densities and high melting point and boiling point because of they are metals. Okay? Okay. So kalau tengok kat sini, yang ini tak terlibat sebab dia kat bawah ni. Alright, so scandium and zinc are not considered as transitions element because both do not show characteristic of transitions element. So what are the characteristic that transition element should have? So here, special characteristic for several transitions element in periodic table of elements, kita tengok kat sini. First, okay. Transitions element function as a catalyst. So, catalyst ada functions dia iaitu to increase the rate of reactions without undergoing chemical change at the end of reactions. So, ataupun dalam bahasa mudah dia, dia speed up reactions. Okay, without undergoing chemical change. Maksudnya kita tambah katalis tetapi dia tidak merubah produk yang akan terhasil. Dia hanyalah untuk speed up the rate of reactions ataupun increase, mempercepatkan proses tu berlaku. Contohnya Haber process. Haber process is the process to produce ammonia gas. So kita pakai nitrogen gas dengan hydrogen gas, kita react. So since kita nak cepatkan proses tu, kita perlukan katalis. Katalis dia adalah iron. So iron ni bertanggungjawab untuk speed up the rate of reactions. But then at the same time, dia tak terlibat, dia tak involve dalam chemical change. Ha, okay, so that's why lah sini tiba tak ada pun iron kan. Dia ada NH3 je. Memang produk daripada reactant tu lah. So tugas dia hanya speed up the rate of reactions. Okay, number two, transitions element form colored iron ore compound. This is the famous answer written by students lah. Kalau soalan tanya what is the characteristic of transition element, student suka jawab ni. Dia ada color. So contohnya chromium. Chromium ada green color. So dichromate orange. Okay, manganese, semua ada color yang cantik-cantik ni. Okay, so itulah specialnya transitions elements. Tengok kat sini color. This one, this all color solutions is come from transitions element. Alright, so next is transitions element have more than one oxidation number. Alright, so state dia. Okay, kita tengok kat sini, chromium, dia ada more than one charge. Positive 3 and positive 6. Okay, plus 3 plus 6. So, chromium 3 ni, okay, Roman 3 ni menunjukkan charge dia plus 3. Okay, so next, manganese. So, manganese ada plus 2, plus 4, plus 7. Tengok pada Roman dia. Okay, so contohlah iron. Iron pun ada lebih daripada 1 juga, plus 2 dengan plus 3. So, ni tengok kat sini, iron 2 plus. Okay, bila kita buat iron 2 plus, so, bila dah different charge, so dia akan berlainan chemical formula. Contoh, iron 2 chloride. Kita cuba kat sini. So, chemical formula dia, since dia Fe2 plus dengan Cl minus, so dia akan jadi FeCl2. Kalau iron 3, chloride. So, dia antara Fe3 plus dengan Cl minus. So, dia akan jadi FeCl3. Dah lain dah chemical formula. So, that's why you have to take note lah. Roman ni 2. So, dia maksudnya dia ada charge plus 2. Okay, Roman 3 plus 3. Sama juga dengan copper. Plus 1 dengan plus 2. So, copper oxide Cu2O. Kalau copper oxide CuO sebab Cu2 plus dengan O2 minus. Kita cross, cross dapat 2-2 and then kita simplify dia. So, 1-1 sebab tu dapat CuO. Okay, next is transitions element can form complex ions. Complex ion yang complicated macam ni. Tetra, I mean copper 2 ion. So, 2 referring to the charge lah kan. Tengok ni, 2 plus. Okay, ni hexocyanoferrate ni 3 minus lah macam tu lah. 3, Roman 3. Okay. Alright, so that's all for the special characteristic for transitions element. So, next is the uses of transitions element in industry. Biasanya kita guna dalam proses yang in dalam industri lah as a catalyst. Okay. Ni kita pakai catalyst. Macam teacher bagi tahu tadi, catalyst tujuan dia untuk speed up the rate of fractions. Tapi dia tak terlibat dalam chemical reactions tu. Dia hanya speed up sahaja. Contoh iron. So kita guna dalam proses tadi kan. Production of ammonia. Vanadium oxide. So vanadium oxide kita perlukan catalyst juga untuk cepatkan proses production of sulfuric acid. Platinum. Platinum adalah produk, proses untuk menghasilkan nitric acid. And nickel as well kita guna dalam hydrogenation process. Okay. So ini semua adalah catalyst yang melibatkan transitions element. Okay, selain daripada catalyst, the uses pun banyak juga. Selain daripada tu, contohnya tingkap. Tingkap yang warna-warna ni kan macam kat kampung ni. So, dalam ni ada transitions metals iaitu manganese untuk buat stained glass window. And then iron. Iron ni kalau jambatan besi or landasan kereta api pun, railway track tu, kita pakai iron juga. Okay, paku pun pakai iron juga kan. So, dan ini pula titanium kita guna dalam chart. Okay. Alright, that's all for this subtopic and it means that we finish with chapter 4 periodic table. Okay, so your homework is test yourself 4.7. Okay, that's all from me. Thank you.